distinguished delegates attending this very, very special conference. At the outset, thank you all for being here, and thank you to the organizers for having thought of me to join you at this event and learn from you all at this wonderful event. It was also my privilege to hear Professor Podole just now, who provided us an excellent landscape of what is happening in the higher education domain. When I was asked to spend the next 10-12 minutes with you all, I decided to, without any pre-planning, choose a theme which would be like a continuation of what Dr. Podole discussed. I had thought I would speak today and share with you all today my own reflections on defining quality in higher education. From which perspective, from whose vision, does the whole question of quality get to be looked at in higher education is the point that I'd like to stress as part of this dialogue. As a preliminary point, I must make that in the last 37 years that I have been privileged to be in the teaching career, I haven't had the chance to have at least more than 15,000 students in my classroom with whom I learned in the classroom. I don't think I taught anybody. It is these 15,000 young people with whom I learned in the classroom, and what I would like to share today with you all is based on that learning that these 15,000 young boys and girls have allowed me to benefit from. So whatever I'm going to share today is based on this learning that I have had the privilege to have with my students. To straight focus on the theme that I wanted to talk about, how do we define quality in higher education? And I think this is relevant to all levels of education also. And I would like to start it with a question. Is quality in higher education about procedures and processes? Is quality in higher education about rules and regulations? Is quality in higher education about various frills and facilities? Or, at the end of the day, is quality in higher education about attitudes and aspirations? And is quality in higher education about people and their practices? For too long have we sought to focus on rules, regulations, procedures, practices, facilities, and the various frills that go with that. Has the time come why focusing on all these issues also talk about aspirations of critical stakeholders, attitudes of different people involved in the process, the people and their practices? If this for me were to be the benchmark for quality in higher education, if this for me were to be the prism by which I look at quality in higher education, I'd like to focus on, in the next 8 to 9 minutes, what I would prefer to call the 3 C's of quality in higher education. Again, keeping in mind for me, people and their practices, attitudes and their aspirations, and the aspirations. And the 3 C's for me would be content of higher education, context of higher education, and champions of higher education. I would look at true quality, the depth of quality, the width of quality, the quality of quality of higher education being defined in terms of content of higher education, context of higher education, and what I term as the champions of higher education. Let me come to the first one, the content of higher education. Dr. Baudelaire made that point very, very strongly about what is it that goes on in our classrooms today as learning. And of course, a side point which I am making as an assumption is today's classrooms are not spaces of teaching, but today's classrooms are zones of learning. And if today's classrooms are zones of learning, what is it that is part of content? I will start with two examples and then elaborate. Many years ago, after I completed teaching a course at the university, and I must add, like Professor Podulev, even though I have administrative responsibilities in the university today, I still take 9 hours of classes every week, right from undergraduate teaching to research teaching. I start my day by going to the classroom because, as Dr. Podulev will agree, administration can always be taken care of, but being with students gives you that energy to be able to deal with administration. So many years ago, when I completed a course and was evaluating myself as part of that course, I called in a student and I was talking to her about how did the course go. At the end of the dialogue, she came up with a wonderful statement. She said, "Sir, throughout the course, I had a feeling that you thought, and correct me if I'm wrong, I had a feeling that you thought that I am an underachiever. You always thought that I was an underachiever, not doing what I was capable of according to you." She did not give me a chance to either negate or endorse what she said. She went on to say, "But sir, have you ever asked yourself the question? Have you ever asked yourself the question that are you an over-demander? Forget my being an underachiever. Should higher education provide that wings for my student to fly, or should it be like that oversized baggage which holds them to the ground and prevents them from taking off?" That's my question. I must share with you an experience from many years ago. One day, I was discussing with my colleague what we should do in our classroom, and I am a social science teacher, a political scientist. And this colleague of mine came up to me one day and said, "Sandeep, I want to tell you what I did in my classroom today." I got a little worried because he was a wonderful person, but I have certain questions about his teaching capacity. I asked him, "Sir, what did you do in the classroom?" He came up with a wonderful point, sir. He told me, "Sandeep, I finished Gandhi in the classroom. I finished Gandhi in the classroom." I didn't want to ask him, "Which Gandhi are you talking about?" But then I asked him another question. And before that, I thought in my mind, what must have happened in his classroom? He must have taught Gandhi so well that Gandhi is finished. But then I asked him a second question, "Sir, why did you finish Gandhi today in the classroom?" He came up with a better answer. He said, "Sandeep, you don't understand. If I did not finish Gandhi today, how will I finish Nehru tomorrow?" Is content all about finishing one after the other? Or is content about those wings that should allow my student, once he is no longer in my classroom, but outside in that open world, to be able to fly? More than less, I had a similar experience. Once when teaching in an American university, as I landed there, I suddenly saw a fellow Indian young boy. And he said, "Sir, you from India?" I said, "I from India. I also from India, sir." He seemed very happy to see somebody from India, which actually is very rare when two Indians meet abroad. But this boy was very happy to see me. And then he said, "Sir, this is my first time abroad." I said, "Very good. What have you studied?" "Sir, I am gold medalist from IIT." I said, "Wonderful. What are you doing here?" "Sir, I am doing my PhD here." I said, "Excellent." And then we became friends. After 2 weeks, suddenly one day he came to me. I said, "What happened?" I asked him. He said, "Sir, today, very important day in my life, sir." I got a little worried. Why is it such an important day in his life? Has he found somebody here in the US to make special his own life? And before I could ask him, he said, "Sir, today my first assignment is coming back." I said, "Very good. I want to know what my teacher thinks about my work." I said, "Excellent." Evening, I tried to find him everywhere, nowhere to be found. Finally, I saw him sitting alone in the garden, and I tapped him on his back and I said, "What happened?" He gave me the assignment. The assignment was written. It was written there by the professor, "Wonderfully done." I said, "Why? What's your problem? It says wonderfully done." He says, "Sir, read the next line." And what was the next line? The next line said, next time, I want your views also. Next time I want your views also. He said, "Sir, first time in my life somebody has asked me for my views also. First time after 22 years somebody is asking me for my views also." So friends, for me, in reverse gear, quality is about the role of the champions, the role of how much role do we give the context of education, and finally, where do we place the content of education? Not for me rules and regulations, not for me procedures and processes, not for me facilities and frills. It's about people and their practices. Thank you all for being such a wonderful audience. I don't know if there is scope for Q&A session. If there is, I'll be happy to respond to questions. If not, I can discuss the questions offline also with you. Thank you, sir. Thank you.